please remember when we first got into the band, those cream and wine things like that we wore?
Really,
how could you forget?
It was the very first picture.
It was fine.
Oh, yeah.
It was bad.
It wasn't you just the clothes, though, was it? It was everything.
It was the hair. Girls our age who were watching us dress like that must have been thinking, what are you doing?
Yeah, but at the end of the day, we've grown up as well. Our style's changed over the years, so everyone goes through phases as well.
Do you remember when we first started wearing, though, the combats and heels combo?
Yeah.
Everyone really did catch on to it.
So I remember going home and one of my friends saying, I'm wearing the Girls Aloud pants, and I was like, what's the Girls Aloud pants? And she said the combat and the heels, and I was we were totally unaware that
but
anyone...
it was good that we had that right from the start, that we kind of did have a style. The No Good Advice video with the silver random space outfits, like we've just been dropped from the sky into a set with a car.
How did we ever think that was a good idea? Spandex,
silver foil,
basically. Tinfoil.
Don't you think the funny thing about us wearing all those outfits was we did actually think they were okay? Like, we didn't.
But do you know, the next couple of things we had the stylist. And we thought, oh my god, they must know what they're talking about, surely. And they told us silver was coming in.
Exactly.
So we went all
went. And it's like safety in numbers, isn't it? It's like all five of us are wearing it.
Oh my god, it was on its way in, people seen us in it, and it was like on its way back out.
I think though, like over the past few years, really, since we got Victoria, I think we've all kind of learnt what looks good and what looks bad a bit more, haven't we?
To be honest, I don't think stale or like fashion wasn't high on our agenda before.
No.
It still isn't on me personally. Yeah. I know a couple of us do really like the fashion side of things, but for me, I don't really.
You like what you like.
I like what I like, whether it's from Topshop, Miss Selfridge, or Prada, Fendi, whatever. I like it if I like it. I'm not a label girl.
And it's different styling for a band as well, isn't it? So what one person might not like. I think it's really good though, in a way, that we all are so different, because it makes it easier when we are picking clothes and stuff. Because like Nadine, you'd always be happy enough to get your legs out, wouldn't you? Whereas I would never choose to, really. Now and again I might, but I would rarely choose to.
Because we are all such different shapes and sizes. Sometimes you do have to compromise on a look where you wouldn't particularly be that happy with it personally. But as a band, it works. Like, I don't particularly like wearing skirts either. But if it's going to look strong for us all to wear a dress, then we compromise and say, OK, well, I'll wear it if it's going to make a bigger impact for the band. First video where we all were kind of uniformed was probably Biology, wasn't it?
Yeah,
where we all had that look,
didn't we?
And the same colours.
Yeah.
But again, it was still to fit into people's shapes. Like, although we all had this, it was like little details that were better suited to that person. Before we were in the band, you wouldn't have been able to get anything that was really fashionable. It was just like casual high street clothing, and fashion was a totally different thing. Whereas now they take inspiration from fashion and create their own
little designer labels within the high
street. Yeah, smart. The only way I would really go over the top and spend a huge amount of money on something, if it's timeless.
Yeah.
You can wear it in years to come. Like a little black dress.
Right, guys. Got a few CDs for us to look at.
No.
A few blasts from the past.
Oh, no.
Okay. I see the day. That's not that old, really.
It's all right.
Well, you're
still
a bit...
ugly though. Ugly as sun.
A bit girly for me.
No, I quite like that. I really like those dresses. I know they're a bit different.
They're just really pretty, aren't they? Weird.
You feel like a girl fairy in them. I like it. Will you ever see the this is horrendous,
oh,
I'll be honest. This is, I think we're alone now.
Oh, I am.
And they went on some mad, like, rave kind
of. That was kind of a weird patch we went through.
Sarah, I think you look gorgeous.
It's quite punky, isn't it?
As for the rest of us.
Well, we can show you some. I'm sure there's somewhere I looked.
What's this?
What is this?
Dog rough on some.
Wake me up.
No. No, you see, this is definitely a losing.
Why do we look sweaty?
I mean,
we look like the sweat dropping off. Yeah. Wake me up before I drop out on you. You treat me rough to show that you care, and I just can't refuse, baby. If I had a promise from you.
Oh my
not
god.
The worst. They're definitely worse.
But they were easy to dance in anyway. The heels were not that big.
Put it down.
Scarred. Scarred enough.
Oh, yes. Gorgeous.
This is the one I was talking about.
Hair and makeup, I can't complain.
Sarah, you look gorgeous
this
again.
This is no good advice.
Hair and makeup, fine.
You look outfit. Twiggy or was blonde.
Blondie.
Right, this is coming. Red and black the first time round.
And what are they?
The tone of things.
I like a witch with that long skirt.
I'm gonna say, it wasn't really our thing at the time.
Cheryl, I don't.
That's not me. I don't need no good advice.
I'm already wasted. No, no. I'll stand
that's
by
weird.
You.
That was really the same bad. Day as the sweaty day.
Yeah.
That just looks cheap, I'm going to be honest. It's just like different.
I got that top in a market or something.
Yeah, random coloured tops.
Well, I got away with it quite lightly. I'm hidden behind all yous. Preferred something from the video.
I got away lightly on that one actually. Because
really?
Yeah, I've got a more expensive top on as well. It's actually got something going on with it.
I like my hair colour.
I think I just look like a transvestite.
No sensation hair. Oh, biology.
That's quite
biology,
good.
I think, is when it was a turning point.
This single sleeve, I really love it.
I really like really the test tube ones that we did as well.
Yeah, and it's a move forward from the others.
I think we started to look a bit more grown up in biology.
I just love how strong it is and the fact that everybody, I think everybody looks really good.
Let's pull another one out of the bag then.
Oh, the Karate Kids!
I really like that.
We look like we're about to go for a game of what's it, karate?
Oh, do you not like that?
I really like it. Yeah, no, it's nice, but I feel like we're about to go do karate.
I mean, yeah, you do. You are.
I do.
Hi.
I think their clothes are good. I think their clothes are strong.
Yeah,
it's a strong image.
Yeah.
Cute.
We're taking it back, guys.
This is the one I was hoping was not in existence anymore.
Got cold.
Kimberly, you actually loved
it. Our pulses.
Do you remember that cold? Give me a look.
Oh, no, dude. It's funny.
It's bad.
That is awful.
It's terrible.
It's bad.
That was the whole masculine look, wasn't it?
Baggy trousers,
shirts, with man's hair. Trousers, and da da da.
Look at that, that's just not you.
I know.
Last but not least, guys. Love
you see, no, I like that one.
Yeah, me too.
See, I quite like that.
And I know it's all quite colourful, but I think it's fun.
No. I mean, with the hair, it's just like nothing.
Nicola, you do look particularly strange on that picture.
Yeah.
I quite like the weird angle thing, but yeah.
Well, that's one of my
personal favourites. Yours looks like it's been cut out of a personal photograph, just stuck on there.
But that was quite good, like quite fun for that song. Well, it's been interesting looking back at the different outfits.
Interesting, enjoyable, painful, a mixture.
It shows that we've progressed and we've definitely moved with the times and moved on our own.
We've grown up as well, I think.
Yeah.
Because we're a lot younger when we started.
But it's just nice to see us looking so young and baby faced and not having terrible clothes and hair to then being like now being quite happy with how we dress and stuff. Yeah. It's nice.
It's been fun though.
And that's only been 5 years. Can you imagine in 5 years from now?
We'll probably look back and think.
We'll be going.
She loves animals. She changes her hair every other week, really. She likes to eat cherry tomatoes dipped in salt, and her puppy has just had babies.
Oh no. Looks like you've caught me with no makeup on, but since you're here, you may as well stay and watch how it's done. And fortunately for me, I've got Liz here who helps me put my makeup on, so I'm really lucky to have her, otherwise, God knows what would happen. Since I've been in Girls Aloud, I've definitely become more aware of makeup. I was never really into makeup that much beforehand. So, yeah, especially with what we do as well, you know, lights and stuff like that can bleach a lot of it out. So we have to wear makeup for TV and stuff like that. And also, you never quite know when the paparazzi is going to catch you out. So you always want to look reasonably well. Have a little bit on. Else you see yourself in the paper a week later with spot cream on your face. Yeah, I did get caught with spot cream on my face and no makeup on. And it wasn't a nice thing to look at, so I've definitely been made more aware of it. And I like to keep on top of, you know, my eyebrows and stuff like that, so I'm more aware of everything on my face now.
I normally tend to have my little makeup bag, and what I would have in there is the face and body foundation that's really light on your skin. It's like a second skin almost, just to, you know, cover it and make it all look one tone. I would have a little bit of lip balm for your lips just to keep them nice. I'm a little bit embarrassed at the state of this makeup bag. Eyeliner. I would only put a tiny little bit on. You can see I use it quite a lot. But if I was to go on a desert island and I had to have a necessity makeup item, it would have to be my Elizabeth Arden 8-hour cream. And that's because it has lots of use. It is a skin protectant. I would put it on the cheeks for a little bit of a dewy look. I would put it on the lips for a little bit of a gloss. And it's also got medicated stuff in, you know, for minor skin irritations and stuff like that. So it's very useful. You can also put a little bit on your eyelashes or your eyebrows before you go to bed, and it helps them to grow, apparently.
I always make sure before I go to bed that I've got every bit of makeup off my face. I wash it with a face wash thoroughly and moisturise it so that it can get cleanse itself overnight and rejuvenate itself for the morning time. I would never go to sleep with a full face of makeup on. If I've got a spot, do you know any quick ways of getting rid of it?
Well, there's loads of different spot creams out that you can use to dry them out.
You used a really good one on Nicola there.
Yeah, I used the Origins Spot Remover. But if you haven't got that toothpaste, good old toothpaste.
Does it work?
It's the best thing ever yet. Just dries it, draws it out and dries it out. I always use toothpaste. On myself, yeah, it's easy. But obviously you can't walk around with toothpaste on your face. So if you can indulge yourself and buy something like Origins, that's...
Yeah, I've also used Sudocrem before, which is actually on the tongue. It's for acne, it's for baby
rash. That's right.
But it works.
Some people do use Sudocrem. Okay, so we're all prepped and ready to go. Just going to set your eyebrows. Cheryl's got wonderful eyebrows. She's grown them all back and they're all gorgeous.
I plucked them within an inch of their lives about a year ago, and that was a big mistake. Don't ever do that. Don't pluck them too thin because it's really not a nice look. You want them to be a normal size but a nice shape.
And it's very on trend now to have.
If you can get brown, if you can get somebody, if you can get somebody to wax them, they can shape them for you. Can or threading. Threading's a really good thing for eyebrows because it can get the tiniest, tiniest little hair out.
Just don't get tweezer happy.
Just don't get too happy and take it all off. It's really not a good look.
So we're all ready to go. Start with some cheeks. We like to use cream blushes. It's a bit more youthful than using the powder.
And sometimes with powder, when you put the powder on, you can see, can't you? Exactly. Sits on top of the makeup.
On top of your skin. So we're going for a little cream blush. Day wear cream.
If we were on TV, we would use powder, wouldn't we?
We would. We use quite a lot when we're on TV. We kind of go to the extreme. But as this is like Cheryl shopping, we're just going for a light.
And I just like to straighten up that I don't have Liz over when I go shopping. This is purely for your benefit. I just put a little bit on myself.
We've got a cream blush. And apples of the cheeks. Like a rosy, healthy rosy colour.
Sometimes as well, let's say if you smile when you put, you
smile,
apply the...
You'll get the apples of the cheeks.
They're what you call the apples.
There we go. So over to you, my love.
This is when you see the look all come together. I always leave mascara to the last, don't we?
Yeah.
Especially if you're applying the likes of eyeshadow, because sometimes it can fall in your lashes and make them the colour of the shadow. So I always put on my own mascara. Not that I don't trust Liz, I just prefer to do my own. Okay, so when I'm putting on my mascara, I tend to try and get every single eyelash, even the tiny little ones in the corner, because it makes you look like you've got a fuller eye. Also, I'm quite fortunate in a way that I've got quite long eyelashes, but so I do use a thicker mascara to thicken them. And if you've got really short eyelashes, you should use a lengthening mascara to lengthen them. So that's the trick. I would apply it underneath my eyelash first and then maybe put a bit downwards on the top just to give them a little bit more thickness.
Should we go?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is where Liz got the eyelashes for our latest video, and she's going to put them on me and show you how to apply them.
These lashes are really extreme. Normally, you use something a bit more natural. Just do a fine, fine line, apply them, and then reapply your line afterwards. But again, keep it really fine and close to the lash. So you apply the line.
Yes.
And we're going to go for the full-on lash look.
Which ones?
I think we're going to go for sexy no-no-no lashes, but the ones that I used on Nicola.
Oh, yes. Did you tell her no, no, no? Give him kisses, no,
no, no. Whisper her lay, no, no, no. Gotta listen. Where else can you buy lashes that come in a box like this?
They're pretty hard to apply, do you not think, on your own?
They are, but I mean, it's a tricky thing with lashes, but it's a case of practising. This makeup house, Shimura, just invented this fantastic little product that's been designed to make you,
there
we go.
Oh,
just apply them yourself, so you'd hold them, you see where you place them, and it follows the shape of the eye. So here we go, there's our lash, a little bit of eyelash glue.
And soon I'm gonna look like a bird. What are you doing there?
I'm just applying the eyelash glue on the end of my brush, and then
so you need to make thin to put the glue on?
Yeah, exactly. You don't want to put too much glue on, otherwise then you'll be left with loads of glue on your eye. And you leave it for a second.
Yes, people have told me you need to wait until it goes sticky.
Yeah, don't put them straight on, because then it'll just wobble about.
I would only ever really put on false eyelashes, though, like something like this, maybe for a fancy dress. Or
a video shoot.
A video shoot, but something normally more
very
natural looking.
Yeah, just to build up the lash rather than to
if you're going
make
to
a
like
effect.
A wedding or somewhere really glamorous.
Yeah.
But other than that, I wouldn't really wear eyelashes, not just to go out for dinner or anything.
Wow.
Wow.
That's pretty fantastic.
That's pretty
isn't it?
Full on, isn't it? And it's funny because they actually feel quite light, even though they look quite dramatic.
It's cheaper lashes, they tend to be a lot heavier because they're made of like plastic or whatever. These are made out of, you know, they're feathers and they're, you know, just like a work of art in itself.
Yeah.
So that's why they feel really, really light. generally, if you are doing like really dark eyes or something, it's best to keep your lips neutral. Cheryl, look at you.
I think a lot of the younger girls look up to us.
Yeah, exactly.
And they like to see how we're doing our hair, and they like to see what we're doing with our makeup. So in that respect, I definitely think we have a responsibility, and I'm sure they'll love the new lashes and stuff on the new video. Yeah. You know, all the younger girls can get dressed up and stuff like that. And there was once a troop of young girls turned up to a gig, all as a different member with their hair the same and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So that's really nice. You know what's strange? I actually prefer shopping for makeup than I do for clothes.
Do you?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I think it's exciting, you know, all the new colours out and all the different things you can experiment with.
Yeah.
You know, different lashes, different colour blushes and lipsticks.
It's really interesting you say that.
Yeah. I much prefer it. I find it far less stressful. I find it really enjoyable.
That's good.
Mm.
Lip gloss, my dear?
A little bit done. I've had a great day having my eyelashes stuck on, so thank you very much.
My pleasure, Cheryl.
If you can't find a nail varnish remover to remove the nail varnish you've got on, put on another fresh layer on top of that one and the underneath layer comes off as well. Pluck your eyebrows only when you come out of the shower or out of a hot bath, because the steam really opens up your pores and it doesn't hurt as much when you pluck them. If you're looking for a natural foundation look and you want a really nice tinted moisturiser, the best way of going about it is to just add a little bit of your foundation to your favourite moisturiser and put it on that way. It makes a really lovely tinted moisturiser. To reduce puffiness around the eye area, the best thing you can do is cut cucumbers into slices, put them in the fridge so they're freezing cold, and when you're having a bath, just put them on your eyes.
She is always on time. I've seen her once with her hair bright red. Wasn't for long. She likes to keep everything nice and organized. That's the kind of girl she is.
I'm just here today with my sister Sally, and we're just doing a bit of internet shopping because I've got a wedding to go to in a few weeks. So I'm trying to find something on the internet because I haven't really got much time to go shopping. I've only just really recently got into the whole internet shopping thing. I do go on there and look at clothes quite a lot. It's just when you don't have the time really to go shopping. I might go like locally, just nip to a couple of shops that are near me, but actually going into town, I don't really get the chance that much. We've looked at quite a few websites, haven't we? And we're on the Topshop one at the moment, and some really good stuff. So we're just gonna have a look through. You go into the cubicles in shops. I don't know if you've noticed, anybody at home, but the mirrors are horrific. Oh. If I judged the clothes on what I see in those mirrors, I'd never buy a thing. So the good thing about internet shopping is you can look at the things, try them on in your own time, in your own mirror. I don't normally dress like this to lounge around and do internet shopping, but I knew you were coming, so I thought I'd make a bit of effort. Otherwise, I'd be in a tracksuit, definitely.
Or pyjamas.
Yeah. Actually, that's the best time to shop on the internet at night, when you're in your pyjamas and you get a bit bored if there's nothing on TV.
Yeah, but it's dangerous, because that's when you make too many purchases.
And I think you make silly decisions at night as well.
Yeah, and more frivolous when you're online, because it's just a click and you've bought it. You don't have that queuing time where you can change your mind and put it back on the rack.
Yes.
Think before you click.
Yes. I ordered a few things, actually, a couple of days ago that I've still not tried on, so I'll try them on for you in a bit. That was one of the things I ordered, but I think it looks quite dressy, so maybe dressy enough for a wedding. This was the brown one that I was showing you. Quite like the two-tone,
yeah.
The two different colours, but it doesn't really seem special enough for a wedding, really. Well, I got these, but they look really high. They look a bit like they might rock a bit as well, like you might not really be able to walk in them very easily. They're more comfortable than they look, but could maybe spare it for a night out for the cause, but not for a wedding.
If it's not right or you don't like it, you don't need any reason to send it back.
This one, I thought it looked all right on the picture, but now I've got it, I think it looks a bit cheap, so I'm not even going to bother trying that one on, to be honest. That one's getting sent straight back. I think I'm going to try this green one on. This one's actually really nice. I'm quite pleasantly surprised. It's quite wedding-y as well, isn't it? This is Topshop as well.
Is it?
Yeah.
See, after that one.
They're
more expensive than Topshop. Nobody would know, but it is really nice.
When obviously I was growing up and I didn't have as much money, I just would try and borrow things off you more than buy my own things because I couldn't really afford it. But now I think when you've got the luxury of actually being able to buy yourself a nice treat now and again, I suppose you can explore style a bit more because you can try out different things, whereas if you've only got however much money to buy things with, you need to make sure it's things that you can wear, and that was why I always tended to go for really simple things that I could wear a few times and maybe wear them a bit differently. Yeah, we used to design our own clothes all the time because my mum used to be really good at making clothes. Me and her and my auntie had their own like clothes making business. But it did work out well for us, didn't it? Because we could like think of an outfit in our head, design it, and then she'd make it for us. We did that loads of times, didn't we?
She made us, we once went to a Christmas disco, and my mum made a lot of our clothes, and she made us a special outfit, which was a gold puffball skirt with a black waistband, and a black polo neck with a gold flower on, but we had different flowers. Lace tights, hair in a side ponytail. We walked into that party.
It was Sally's idea, by the way.
No, it wasn't.
It was. I was too young to know. I just went along with it, thinking it was cool.
Yeah, well, we regretted it, because we walked in there thinking everyone was going to go, wow. Well, they did go, wow. For all the wrong reasons, it was more like, wow.
Wow, you are upstaging this party.
You two are attention seekers. Yeah,
they were bright gold, like almost like foil, weren't they? Like they puffed right out. They were quite good though.
Yeah, for a fancy dress.
Our poor mum stayed up all night making them for us.
And we designed them.
Sometimes they're actually on this website. Like when I think it was around Love Machine when I had the pink dress. Lipsy then made the dress to sell. And so then I was on, as seen on screen, so then if I go on there, I feel a bit...
Did you feel like you made it?
I felt like I'd really made it for getting on.
Like when your music's played in the back of Coronation Street.
Yeah.
Or you're on, as seen on screen,
you know you've got somewhere. I ordered this in the yellow and the green.
Quite a nice colour green.
Yeah, that really suits you.
What about
shoes,
then? No, I ordered these.
Well,
they'd be perfect.
Well, I don't want to be too overdressed.
No, I think that's just right.
It's best to keep it a bit understated if you're going to someone else's wedding.
Quite a nice yellow, isn't it?
Yeah.
If you're going to internet shop, make sure you've got somebody with you when you try the clothes on, because sometimes you lose perspective a bit. I like this one. I don't really know which one I prefer out of the yellow and the green of this one. And I like the satin green one, I don't know. What do you think?
Maybe you should buy them all. I can wear one, you can wear one.
That could be a plan of action. I'm sure we'll get a chance to wear them at some stage, but this is quite wedding-ish, I feel like, quite wedding-y, isn't it? My first tip is always compare prices on the different websites before you buy. Never tell anyone your password for your online account, not even your friends or your sisters, don't tell anyone. Make sure you've got permission to use the person's credit card if you're under 18. Always watch out for additional charges, just be careful.
Shall
She's always late. Her phone is continuously on vibrate, so she never picks the phone up when you ring her. She's got a personality like a box of chocolates. You never know which one you're gonna get. And she loves a party. She's good fun.
I'm a bit of a shopaholic. It doesn't necessarily matter what I'm buying, it's just something new. I'm like a magpie. I love places like this. We're in Shoreditch today, generally because I'm not really from around this area. When I'm here, I love to come and look in like off-the-hook kind of shops. For me personally, if I'm accessorising a lot, then I tend to keep the dressing quite simple. I went to the Cartier polo match and I wore quite a simple CNC from my friend's boutique. Very simple kind of vest dress, long dress with a split down the side. But I teamed it up with some really chunky gold jewellery by Lara Bonick, which was exactly the look I was going for. Never necklace and earrings together, I just think it's a bit too much. If it's more simple, then yeah, you could probably get away with a necklace, but don't do big earrings with big necklaces, it's just a big no-no. I love going to places like Topshop and high street shops and Selfridge. I like a bit of everything, but then I'll throw in the obvious designer thing, or I might have a designer pair of sunglasses or a designer pair of shoes. I very rarely buy a lot of designer clothes, and if I do, I always make sure it's a real classic, usually quite a nice classic black number or something that's not going to really just be in one minute and out the next, because I can't warrant spending that amount of money on something that's going to kind of be out of trend in the next season. I think you can overdo designer. If you're just head to toe in designer, I think it can look quite tacky. I'm really quite into shift dresses at the moment, kind of just where you don't feel like you're kind of really, like, say, imagine this dress without the belt on, it would probably be a little bit more maybe shapeless, but then I'd probably dress it up with a pair of earrings or whatever, because of my hairdo, I suppose. No one's amazing all the time, no one's perfect, and I think, especially, I suppose, with what we do, when we are going to get followed, it's always handy to have a pair of glasses with you, come rain or shine. I find a lot of designer sunglasses, they're usually really wide on my face. I think I've got quite a narrow head. I've got a bit of a pea head. I'm probably the most indecisive person you'll ever come across. I can stand there for hours deliberating what I should or shouldn't get. So I always make sure I've got a good, honest friend with me. No. I quite like these. They're a bit different. They're not actual Ray-Bans, but they're very similar. They actually probably suit me better than the actual Ray-Bans. So there you go, there's a prime example. You don't have to go for the name. So I think I'll be getting a pair of those. I love going shopping when I'm abroad because you can also get some wicked stuff. I've got a wicked pair of glasses quite similar to these, which I bought in Melbourne. And they're still on the brink of death. They've been squashed a good few times and I'm trying to save them. And I've warned, I think it was Kimberly last time, she trod on them when we were on tour and I could have killed her. My biggest tip about sunglasses is not to be afraid to be a little bit flamboyant. If it suits you or the outfit you're wearing, then just go for it. Don't be afraid to mix and match. I mean, if you want to feel a little bit special and get something pretty, like, amazing, then spend a bit of money, but make sure it's not something you're only going to wear once. So there's three, there's two. Being a girl, you can't just stop in one shop. It's time to move on to the next, so come with me. Daddy told me look into the future, sit at... I seem to have picked quite a lot out in these earrings. I bought them here last time we were doing... It was actually the Sunsilk advert we shot here, and I ended up taking away a few pieces with me. They're my most favourite accessory earring of the moment. So if you look back, you'll probably notice that I'm wearing them quite a lot. Big earrings like that, especially having short hair, yeah, probably would be more of a kind of 60s feel. So it's kind of the vibe that I'm going for at the moment. I love how everything eventually goes full circle. My mum will say to me, oh my God, if I'd have just kept those boots in the wardrobe, they could have been reused, you know. It's actually quite nice having something that's worn in and kind of old looking. It doesn't look too brand spanking new as well. I don't really have a particular style. I have
I just think if I like something, I see it, I can make it work to how I'd probably want it to work. I'm not really a typical dressy kind of girl. You know, you wouldn't see me flouncing about in a ball gown, naturally anyway. But I've always been a little bit tomboyish. But then when I look like a lady, I know how to act like a lady. I have got a bit of a tendency to like really off-the-cuff jewellery and stuff, and there's a few bits over there. I'm scared to ask how much they are.
These are amazing. Really like these. You could be a winner.
Personally, it's more about what makes me feel comfortable. If I don't want to make an effort and I don't want to bother, if I'm just going down the local supermarket, I'll just throw a pair of trackies on and my boots. I'm not really too fussed. But if I'm going out somewhere nice for dinner or going out with some mates to a club, then of course I'm going to want to look nice. In War Taxi Divine, they all made us little necklaces with our names on them for the biology video. We were wearing a lot of red and black and accessorising with the red belts. Very kind of hourglassy. And the necklaces were just kind of nice, a nice little finishing touch. Just personalised it a little bit more. And they made them in with our names on them as well, which is really sweet of them. I think we got to keep them. I think they're probably still in our stylist wardrobe. I don't just wear what I'm told, and I do have my own kind of style, and I think that's only really developed over the last couple of years. Even now, I'll look back even 3 years ago and go, oh, my God, we didn't wear that, did we? Like, little crop top and jeans and things like that, very girly. OK, so that's me done for today. I hope you picked up some helpful hints on how to accessorise. I'm off for my disco nap now. Choosing the right accessories can make or break an outfit and also boost your confidence, so make sure you choose wisely. I think you should spend more time in the mirror before you go out, the day before or a couple of hours before, so you're not rushing at the last minute. Make sure you have a special place for each and every part of your accessory drawer, so i.e. one for belts, one for bags and one for jewellery. Don't overload a small bag. Always have a big bag. They're very handy, especially like us when we're working quite long hours, to put absolutely everything you need in them. Okay, she's well known for having the longest legs in pop. She's a very keen cook, like myself, and also usually quite late for everything.
Hello. Today we're going to be going shoe shopping. I have one of those things that I really, really hate, my feet. Some people hate their hands, their arms. I hate my feet. So I'm going to take you around, show you some shoes and different options that you can do for things, you know, like open-toed sandals that don't show too much but are still nice and summery. I brought my sister, Rachel, to help us, and she can steer me in the right direction because sometimes I can get carried away. One more to go. I'm going to get changed and then another outfit.
Oh, you're terrible.
Why?
Because you always change. Just make your mind up before you put it on and then, you know, put it on you and whatever.
You'll love it when I come out.
Aye. This one or the next one?
I don't know yet. Okay, so now this is a dress that you could wear both either day or night. I'm going to start off with daytime. And because I'm a heels girl,
it has to be heels, even though it's the daytime. I think I would go for these black ones, just because they're kind of casual.
And have them for, you know, if I was going for lunch or
going to do something. Do you like?
I like those.
And then I'll show you what I'm going to do when I'm going to wear this for nighttime. This is the evening wear beginning. I've put some tights on. I haven't yet chose shoes, but I'm going to choose jewellery. So now if I take off my own, I've got, and put a necklace with it. And
There'll be a bracelet. And we'll go and try these shoes on. We'll try on these. These Aldo ones, patent, which is really good. When shoes are shiny, I can, you know, draw more attention to them and stuff. Especially because I'm wearing black tights. You can see the contrast. Oh, I love these. I really love these. Are these a winner? Happy days! We have day shoes and night shoes. Basically, I wear heels all the time. Actually, I went through a stage of wearing UGG boots, but I had heels in my bag because I was wearing the UGGs on the way to choreography, and then putting the stilettos on when I got there, and then putting the UGGs on again because you needed something really comfortable. But they're like high slippers, really. You don't class them as shoes.
The closest you would get to Nadine not wearing a heel that is still a shoe and not a flip-flop would be maybe once in a blue moon a pair of cowboy boots. When she decides to wear jeans, which isn't very often.
And here is my shopping outfit. Does not look bad, it looks more shopping than before. Same shoes though. I would normally wear something like this to shop. I like to dress up. I like to feel like I'm wearing something that's dressy and that you could go anywhere. Because you never know sometimes when you go out and you don't expect the day to take you, you know, day a restaurant with friends or to a friend's house or whatever. So you want to be prepared for every eventuality. So when you dress up in the morning and let it carry you through the whole day until night. All right, let's go. I've asked for some shoes in my size. Here they are. Well, I got really adventurous with myself. I asked for a pair of boots like this, and they got my size 6 in them. I'll try these on. No stuff on them. I think these are really nice, just for, like, you know, if you had a dress or something. When we were doing tour rehearsals, this is how it began from our very first tour, what will the neighbour say to her? I decided to rehearse in heels, so it was when it came to doing the show, I could dance in any type of heels, and it's really, really worked out. So now I do everything. We do the love machine in heels. Ah! What else do we do in heels? The sound of the underground mic stands in heels. And there's always some kind of hip grinding thing that you wear heels for. And it just helps. It just means that you're always going to be comfortable. I always think that if you buy tan coloured heels, like, you know, roughly the same colour as your skin, and that they make your legs look longer for people that worry about things like that, and this seems to help. I had a pair of tan heels when I first got them. I was addicted. So these are peep toes, and some of the shoes that we looked through earlier in my wardrobe were also peep toes. And it's always important to remember that you put some form of nail polish on. It's not essential that you go and professionally get a pedicure or anything like that, but just something like a nice coat of polish. If you're tanned or have dark skin, it's nice to put peachy, pinky colors on. If you're paler skinned, it's nice to wear like plums, reds, darker colors, richer, warmer colors. Heels are great for showing off legs. If you want to wear a skirt or a dress, just put some heels on. It'll add inches to your legs and nobody will ever know. I don't have a favorite shoe designer. I like some of the things Fendi do. I like some of the Dolce & Gabbana shoes, some of the Gucci shoes.
some of the office shoes. Shelley's do nice boots, and Topshop have gotten some really nice shoes from there before. It doesn't really matter, it just depends on the type of shoe. It's like anything. I don't think there's one specific designer or high street store that it's dead cert to get the most amazing shoes. You have to shop around. Wedges or stilettos? Definitely stilettos. Wedges make, because I have quite thin ankles and calves, they make me look too clumpy. They look like I'm struggling to walk, like I'm like dragging clogs along or something. Well, we done I Think We're Alone Now video. We had these, well, I had these Christian Louboutin, I hope that's how it's pronounced. I'm not offending anybody, but they were cream and amazing. I was almost sick. I just lost to stare at these shoes. Like, our stylist called Victoria. She brought them on. I was like, Victoria, I love these shoes. And I was allowed to take them home, and then I wore them out one night. It was the worst thing I could have ever done. I was so afraid. I was keeping constantly lifting my feet off the ground, and it was really antisocial of me. I was a horrible friend that night over the head of these shoes. Nobody could come anywhere near me. Can we talk about these just for a second?
I just want to ask why.
And this bit here, this handle, it's like a bucket. Put your sand in it and go to the beach. Not put on your feet and go outside the door. I just don't know, that people went crazy with these shoes. I don't know. Let me try them on. Let me see if I'm missing something. I may be like, wow. Oh! Disgusting. Now look, this is Nadine insane. Insane. This is Nadine normal with the black shoes. So we're going to buy these shoes. I went for a real compromise today. Rachel got the super high, the killer heels. And I've gone for something more casual. Well, thank you very much for joining us on our shopping for shoes excursion today. I had a really good time, and I hope you did, and I hope I helped you out with any kind of tips when it comes to shoes, because I love them. A really good tip to know if you've got sore feet from shoes is if you get those party feet, they're kind of like flat jelly looking things, and you put them on your shoes, and it means that the balls of your feet are absolutely fine to go dancing in. So when you buy a new pair of shoes, before you wear them out, it's a good idea to try them around your house, like running up and down the stairs, or, you know, practicing your dance moves, whatever you want to do with them, just so as when you eventually get out, you have no surprises. So if you have small feet, I don't really think that round toes are that good of an idea. They make them look even smaller. So try a pointier stiletto, like a court shoe or something that's longer at the front rather than rounded. She's always laughing somewhere in a corner on her own, sometimes just at her own jokes. She can't ever wear a light coloured thing without getting it filthy dirty. And she's a real sunshine to have around. I enjoy her company, and I've watched her blossom into a gorgeous young woman.
Hello. Well, I'm here today. You've caught me shopping. I'm trying to find a perfect pair of jeans, which I think is really, really difficult. I hate shopping for jeans because you can never find the right pair. You have to go through try thousands of pairs on before you come home with one pair. So that's what I'm doing today. I'm going to try out the body metrics machine that scans your whole body, like centimeter by centimeter, to like find your perfect jeans for your shape.
So you're here for the Made to Measure jeans?
Yes.
And has anybody been through how it works with you?
No.
Okay, well, if you'd like to take a seat with me over here, you just go through it. What we do is we take a scan of you in our pot.
Okay.
We get all your body measurements, and then we use those measurements to make the pattern. Okay, so
yep, that's great.
Style-wise, did you have anything in mind?
I am looking for a high-waisted pair.
Okay.
Of flared ones.
Okay.
Because I can't find them anywhere over there.
Okay, so we got your details. So now what you can, you can come with me into the back. We'll do the scan.
This is cozy.
So this is our scanner room.
Yes.
So what you're going to do is take all the trim that you have off, put on the white that we got over here. It has to be, it does not matter the color that you're having as long as it's really fitted to your body shape.
Okay.
Your hair, if you wouldn't mind just slinging back over your shoulders, and if you have any jewelry on, if you wouldn't mind just taking that off for the scan. Earrings, if you have little earrings, then that's fine.
Then?
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay. Okay, so I'm all changed in my super tight white outfit. If you want to come in and watch me get scanned.
How was the scan?
It's fine.
Slightly strange with all the lights.
Yeah, it was more like a disco than a body scan. Oh my god, it's like looking at myself naked.
Okay, so that's your scan. That's the data that we've collected from it. And what do you think?
Oh, I don't like it. I don't know if I want you to say it. Do you get people like, oh God,
that's not me. Oh. Yes, ma'am. And lots of people don't actually want to see them.
Mm.
Yeah, they just ask if they could just rather not.
Well, how do you feel about me? All the people that's buying this DVD is going to see what I look like with no clothes on.
And how do you feel about that?
Really bad.
Let me put some jeans on so you can
put some jeans on quick. That would be good, actually, to give to Victoria, the stylist, and she'll never have to measure me again. I'm around fashion and I love clothes all the time. You kind of learn a bit more about what suits you best and what looks nice, but before Girls Aloud, I didn't really have the money to be able to have a clue about what to wear or just basically you bought the pair of jeans that you could afford, hope to God that they look okay, and then just go. A tip for buying jeans is it's worth trying on lots of pairs of jeans, even if you just can't be bothered, it's worth it because in the end, you know, it's not like buying a pair of trousers where you can't really see anything, you're covered up. When you've got a pair of jeans on, you can see what your thighs are doing, you can see what your bum's doing. Visually, you can, they're very body conscious, even though they're not meant to be. They are. So I think it's definitely worth just taking the time out, go for a jeans shopping day and just try them all on and just learn what looks nice on you and what doesn't. And take your friend with you and she can tell you as well. Day and night looks, black skinny jeans in the nighttime, you can't really go wrong, to be honest, with a nice pair of heels. Daytime, it depends what your style is. If you want to wear baggy jeans with like your little pumps, your trainers, a little hoodie, or if you want to go a bit more dressed up and you want to go for the straight leg with a nice pair of boots, a nice t-shirt, go for that whole Jennifer Aniston t-shirt and jeans thing. So there's plenty of different occasions you can wear them for. I would die if I didn't have a pair of jeans. The worst style of jeans is jeans with no pockets on the bums. I see people with jeans on with no pockets on their bum. I just don't know how you can do it. Pockets is an essential, even if we have a fitting and this pair of jeans fit me perfectly, I have to get the stylist to sew pockets on the bum for me because I just cannot do it to myself.
Okay, so what we'll do now is we'll go up and we'll get the style that you were looking for, we'll get your size right, and we'll do the measurements, or well, we've got the measurements, so we can see which is going to fit you.
Okay.
Just have a look.
These are obviously too big. Same pair of jeans on, but a smaller size. And they're still too long. And the way they look from the back is not very good. Right. These ones feel really comfortable. They're not too high, but they fit around the leg, they're not too long, and they're quite all right from the back as well. So I think I've actually found a pair. I think the body metrics machine is going to work really well. I'm quite looking forward to seeing what the jeans come out like and how well they fit, what they actually do for my shape. And hopefully they'll be worth the money. I'm pleased that I came to have that done actually. But then again, I have found a pair that do fit just off the normal shelf. You don't have to spend all that money and go through all that fuss just to find a great pair of jeans, because I have today. So I hope you've enjoyed all my tips and I'll see you later. Bye. Great tip for jeans is always wash them inside out, because the colour will always stay for much longer. You should always try to find a great pair of jeans that fit you really well, especially around the waistband. Even if you have to go a size bigger, which you might not want to, but it's much more flattering if you do. The darker the denim, the smaller your legs are going to look. So the lighter the denim, the bigger your thighs are going to look. Pockets on jeans is a necessity. Even if they have tiny pockets, it's still a no-no. There have to be big pockets placed in the right area. Never buy a pair of jeans with no pockets on, ever.
So, have any of you got like two separate perfumes, one that you wear for night, one that you wear for day?
I always try to if you wear something like Chanel, like Coco Mademoiselle is quite deep, isn't it? So for the night out, it stays like all night.
Like Gucci Rush.
But sometimes it's a bit too strong in the day. It's a bit like, gives you a bit of a headache, yeah? Mm-hmm. So something like a light Gucci perfume is more of like a breezy day smell.
Yeah, keep it light for the day and heavy for the night.
I love the perfumes Dior are doing. I've been wearing that same one for a while. It's really sweet.
Yeah,
this and Miss Sherry.
Every time I smell that, I think of you.
And it's funny because he's all smells.
Yeah.
You all have like a sour.
I wear Victor Moral Flower Bomb. I've worn it for over a year now.
I don't stick to one at all.
I didn't used to. I've got like a million. Perfume is my weakness. I've got about a million bottles. But I don't go through them. I stick to the one smell. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I wear Marc Jacobs most of the time, but I've got the two different ones, so I can kind of switch between. But sometimes if I'm gonna like go on holiday, I'll get a new perfume for that holiday, and then I remember the holiday off
from the perfume, I know.
Or even if it's shampoo or whatever, you smell it and you're like, oof.
It's always quite nice to layer it. You know, you get a nice shower gel. Like Calvin Klein Euphoria, they do the body wash, then they do the moisturiser, and then you just spray on. Oh yeah, for a night out, I always religiously and the dressing.
I do the body lotion for a night out as well, so it lasts a bit longer. Yeah,
definitely, that helps.
One of my top tips for mascara is you can't keep it for too long. If when you open it, it doesn't make a nice, fresh, popping noise, then it's time to go in the bin. So definitely throw away mascara after about 2 months. A liquid eyeliner across the eyelashes can be very difficult to put on, so my tip would be use a pencil first to make sure you've got the line perfect, then go over it with the liquid. Waterproof mascara can also be doubled up as waterproof eyeliner if you just dip your eyeliner brush into the waterproof mascara and use that to draw on the line. If you can't find a nail varnish remover to remove the nail varnish you've got on, put on another fresh layer on top of that one and the underneath layer comes off as well. Pluck your eyebrows only when you come out of the shower or out of a hot bath, because the steam really opens up your pores and it doesn't hurt as much when you pluck them. If you're looking for a natural foundation look and you want a really nice tinted moisturiser, the best way of going about it is to just add a little bit of your foundation to your favourite moisturiser and put it on that way, it makes a really lovely tinted moisturiser. To reduce puffiness around the eye area, the best thing you can do is cut cucumbers into slices, put them in the fridge till they're freezing cold, and when you're having a bath, just put them on your eyes.
My first tip is always compare prices on the different websites before you buy. Always shop with companies that you know or ones that have got a good reputation. Always check the company's delivery and returns policy just in case you need to send something back. Never tell anyone your password for your online account, not even your friends or your sisters. Don't tell anyone. Make sure you've got permission to use the person's credit card if you're under 18. Always watch out for additional charges, just be careful.
Don't be afraid to buy something that sometimes does look a bit worn in. Vintage is sometimes more fashionable than new. Choosing the right accessories can make or break an outfit and also boost your confidence, so make sure you choose wisely. I think you should spend more time in the mirror before you go out, the day before or a couple of hours before, so you're not rushing at the last minute. Make sure you have a special place for each and every part of your accessory drawer, so i.e. one for belts, one for bags and one for jewellery. Don't overload a small bag. Always have a big bag. They're very handy, especially like us when we're working quite long hours, to put absolutely everything you need in them.
Okay, so if you're wearing open-toe sandals, it is a must that you have a pedicure because you do not want ugly toes, unmanicured, and just not nice. It's never a good idea to wear them more than 2 days in a row because they can slacken around the bits that hold it together. And then when you put them on again, they just don't fit as good, and it's just always better to give your shoes a break. A really good thing to remember is don't drive with stilettos on. I've done it a few times myself, and it does something weird to the heel. It kind of wears it down and then snap. So it's a good idea to always keep maybe some kind of flats, maybe some kind of other shoes to drive with. A pair of shoes that you really, really love, you can always get them re-heeled if they start looking a bit dodgy. It's a good thing about it. For short and chunky legs, no ankle straps, because you don't want them to disappear and you don't see them at all. It's always good to try and elongate your legs. They have a nice big heel. And if you've got, you know, if you do have bigger legs, you can have something chunky in the bottom to distract from your ankles and calves. A really good tip to know if you've got sore feet from shoes is if you get those party feet, they're kind of like flat, jelly-looking things, and you put them on your shoes, and it means that the balls of your feet are absolutely fine to go dancing in. So when you buy a new pair of shoes, before you wear them out, it's a good idea to try them around your house, like running up and down the stairs or, you know, practicing your dance moves, whatever you want to do with them. Just so as when you eventually get out, you have no surprises. So if you have small feet, I don't really think that round toes are that good of an idea. They make them look even smaller. So try a pointier stiletto, like a court shoe or something that's longer at the front rather than rounded.
Try not to wear jeans and flat shoes because if you're already quite short, it's going to make you look even shorter. If you've got quite big thighs, then try to stay away from the skinny jeans. I know that they're in fashion, but wide leg flared jeans are much more flattering. If you have a really favourite pair that cost a lot of money, you should always try to get them dry clean just so they keep safe. A great tip for jeans is always wash them inside out because the colour will always stay for much longer. You should always try to find a great pair of jeans that fit you really well, especially around the waistband, even if you have to go a size bigger, which you might not want to, but it's much more flattering if you do. The darker the denim, the smaller your legs are going to look. So the lighter the denim,
the bigger your thighs are gonna look. Pockets on jeans is a necessity. Even if they have tiny pockets, it's still a no-no. They have to be big pockets placed in the right area. Never buy a pair of jeans with no pockets on, ever.